show that the set Q plus of all positive rational numbers forms an abelian group under the composition defined by circle such that A circle B is equals to A into B by 3 for A comma B belong to Q plus. What is Q suffix plus or Q superfix plus? Nothing but set of all positive rational numbers. And the circle, the binary operation circle is defined by A circle B equals to AB by 3. That is, we have to multiply A and B and divide by 3. That is, this circle consists of addition as one operation and division is another operation. So the circle consists of two operations here. One is a ordinary multiplication, second one is the ordinary division by 3 for A comma B belong to Q plus. First we have to show that the closure property. What is closure property? Choose any two elements from the set of positive rational numbers and show that A circle B also belongs to the set of all positive rational numbers. That is, A comma B belong to Q plus implies A circle B belongs to Q plus. Actually, this Q suffix plus, let me call this Q plus. We are given that or the binary operation is defined as A circle B equals to AB by 3. And we know that A and B are two positive rational numbers. Then A into B is a positive rational number. Divide by 3 is also a positive rational number. And hence AB by 3 is a positive rational number and hence that belongs to Q plus. For example, if we take A equals to 2, B equals to 4. 2 and 4 are positive rational numbers. Both belong to Q plus. Then what is A circle B? A circle B is defined as AB by 3. That is A into B. 2 into 4, 8. 8 by 3. What is 8 by 3? 8 by 3 is a rational number which is positive. Therefore, 8 by 3 belongs to Q plus. And hence, we say that A circle B also belongs to Q plus. So, whenever A and B are two positive rational numbers, then A circle B is also a positive rational number. And hence Q plus, the elements of Q plus satisfy the closure property. That is, we say that Q suffix plus is closed with respect to the binary operation circle. Now we'll show the associativity. What is the associative axiom? A comma B comma C belong to Q plus implies A circle B circle C is equals to A circle B circle C. Let us consider A circle B circle C. And we know that A circle B is defined as AB by 3. Now that is equals to. Now here consider AB by 3 as one element. C is another element. Therefore this would be of the form first element circle second element. What is the first element circle second element? We have to take the product of these two elements. Therefore the product of these two elements is AB by 3 into C divided by what you have to the denominator 3. Therefore this AB by 3 circle C is AB by 3 into C by 3 by definition of the binary operation. That is equals to A into B into C. This 3 has to come to the denominator. Therefore 3 into 3 and hence that is equals to ABC by 9. So A circle B circle C value is A, B, C by 9. Let us call it as 1. Now we are going to find the right hand, the left hand value, that is A circle, B circle, C. What is A circle, B circle, C? First, let us complete whatever within the bracket. Therefore, it is A circle. What is B circle, C? By definition of the composition, B circle, C will be B into C by 3. Therefore, it is A circle. B circle, C is BC by 3. Now consider A as A and the whole element, that is BC by 3, as B. Then this will be of the form A circle B. What is A circle B? A circle B is A into B by 3. Therefore, A circle BC by 3 becomes A into BC by 3 whole divided by 3. That's the one here. This is A. This is the second element by 3. What is this value? A into B into C divided by 3 into 3 is 9. And hence A into B into C by 9, call it as 2. So from 1 and 2, the right hand side of 1 and 2 are equal, and hence the left hand side of 1 and 2 must be equal. That is A circle B circle C equals to A circle B circle C for all A comma B comma C belong to Q plus. That is set of all rational numbers obey associative property. Therefore, we say that Q plus is associative with respect to the operation circle. Now we have to find the identity. The result says that the identity law says that for all A belong to Q plus, there exists an element E belongs to Q plus such that A circle E equal to A equal to E circle A. Now what is E value? And we have to check whether the E value belongs to Q plus or not. Let us check it. So what is the value of E? To find the value of E, you can take A circle E equals to A, or you can take E circle A equal to A. Any one is enough. Let us consider A circle E equals to A. We know that A circle E is defined as AE by 3. That's by definition of the circle. That is equals to A. Now cross multiply. We get AE equals to A into 3. Now by left cancellation law, we can cancel this A. Therefore, when you cancel A, we get E is equals to 3. And hence, the identity for this group is 3. In general, the additive identity will be 0. But in this case, the circle is defined as A circle B equals to AB by 3. Therefore, here the identity is 3. And 3 is the identity element in the set G, or here the G is nothing but Q plus. The fourth property is existence of inverse. Now we have to show that inverse exists for every element in Q plus. For all A belong to Q plus, there exists B belongs to Q plus such that A circle B equals to E, that is equals to B circle A. This is by definition of inverse axiom. Now how to find the value of B? We have taken A. Now we are going to find the value of B. How do you find the B value? For this, we have to consider either A circle B equal to E or B circle A equals to E, and E value is 3. Just now we have found the value of E. Now consider A circle B equals to E or E equal to 3. What is the value of A circle B? A circle B is nothing but AB by 3 equals to 3. Now cross multiply. When you cross multiply, we get AB is equals to 3 into 3. That is A into B equals to 9. But what do you want? We want to find the value of B. And hence, B equals to 9 by A. Therefore, 9 by A is the therefore, therefore, 9 by A is the inverse of A in Q plus. And remember that A cannot be 0 because A is a positive rational number. We know that 0 is neither positive nor negative. And hence, A cannot be 0. Therefore, 9 by A is defined. And hence, 9 by A is the inverse of A. What is the inverse of 2? We know that 2 is a positive rational number. What is inverse of 2? Just now we have found 9 divided by A is the inverse of A. Now take A equal to 2. Then the inverse of 2 will be 9 by 2. 9 by 2. What is the inverse of 9? The inverse of 9 will be 9 by 9. That is equal to 1. What is the inverse of 3? Inverse of 3 will be 9 by 3. What is 9 by 3? Is 3. So inverse of 3 is 3. Inverse of 10 is 9 by 10. Inverse of 5 is 9 by 5. Inverse of 20 is 9 by 20. Inverse of 90 is 9 by 90. This is how we can find the inverse of every element in Q plus. Therefore, Q plus comma circle is a group. Now finally we have to show that it is abelian. That is, it satisfies the commutative property. A comma B belong to Q plus implies A circle B equal to B circle A. This is the one we have to prove. Let us start with A circle B. Now we have to show that it is equal to B circle A. A circle B is defined as AB by 3. What are A and B? A and B are positive rational numbers. And hence A into B can be written as B into A. Because if you take any two positive rationals, A into B equal to B into A. Therefore, in the place of A into B, we are going to write B into A by 3. If it is A circle B, we have to write A first, B second. But here what is there? B is first, A is second. Therefore, B into A by 3 is nothing but B circle A. That is, A circle B equal to B circle A. It is true for any two elements in the set Q plus. And hence, we say that Q plus comma circle is an abelian group. Prove that the set G of all rational numbers other than 1 is an abelian group with respect to the operation defined by A star B equals to A plus B minus A into B for all A comma B belong to G. That is, A circle B is nothing but, first we have to is take the sum of the given numbers minus product of the given numbers. That is, this star is a combination of three basic operations, namely addition, subtraction and product. So addition, difference and product. So, A circle B is defined as A plus B minus A into B. Here, what are A and B? A and B are rational numbers except 1. What is given here? G is all rational numbers other than 1. Therefore, G equals to Q minus 1. Excluding 1, except 1, we can take any element in the set of rational numbers. Let A comma B belong to G. Whenever we say A and B are elements of G, A and B are nothing but rational numbers other than 1. Other than 1. Therefore, you can write A is not equal to 1 and B is not equal to 1. A and B belong to Q. We shall now show that the elements of G satisfy closure axiom. That is, A comma B belong to G implies A star B also belongs to G. Here, this A star B is defined as A plus B minus A into B. We know that A plus B is sum of A and B. A into B is the product of A and B. Thus, the star is defined as sum of the two numbers minus product of the two numbers. And hence, the circle is, hence the star is a combination of three basic operations, namely addition, subtraction, and multiplication. That is, the star is a combination of sum, difference, and product. Now, what do you have to show? We have to show that A star B belongs to G. In the place of circle, in the place of star, we can have a circle or any other operations except addition, subtraction, and product, also the division. Except these operations, you can use star, circle, any other symbol. Now, it is very clear that A star B equals to A plus B minus AB. Since A and B are rational numbers, A plus B is a rational number. A into B is also a rational number. And the difference of two rational numbers is also a rational number. So clearly, A star B is a rational number. But what's the difficulty in it? We have to show that this A star B is not equal to 1. Is not equal to 1. Therefore, let A comma B belong to G. When you say A comma B belong to G, A and B are rational numbers and A is not equal to 1, B is not equal to 1. Now we have to show that A star B equals to A plus B minus AB belongs to G. As I told you, this A plus B minus AB is a rational number. Then if we show that A plus B minus AB is not equal to 1, then we can conclude that A circle or A star B belongs to G. So how do you prove this? We are going to show this by a contradiction. Therefore, first assume that A plus B minus AB value is 1. Suppose A plus B minus AB equals to 1. Then what happens? Let us see. Take this 1 to the left hand side. Therefore, A plus B minus AB minus 1 is equals to 0. And the above equation can be written as A minus 1 plus B minus A into B equal to 0. Again, this can be written as A minus 1 minus AB plus B equals to 0. Again, this can be written as A minus 1 minus, here take B out. When you take minus B out, B will be having A minus 1 equal to 0. In this case, A minus 1 is a common factor in first term and the second term. Therefore, take it out. When you take A minus 1 out, then we'll be having 1 minus B. equal to 0. This means A minus 1 equal to 0 or 1 minus B equal to 0. When you say A minus 1 equal to 0, A equal to 1. When you say 1 minus B equal to 0, B equal to 1. Thus, we get the value of A is 1 or the value of B equals to 1, which is a contradiction. Why is a contradiction? Because when you say A and B are elements of G, A is not equal to 1 and B is not equal to 1. Now, since we consider A plus B minus AB equal to 1, we get A equal to 1 or B equal to 1, which is against the values of A and B. Therefore, this is a contradiction. This contradiction arises because we assume that A plus B minus AB equal to 1. And hence, A plus B minus AB is not equals to 1. Thus, A comma B belong to G implies A star B belongs to G, because A plus B minus AB is a rational number which is not equal to 1. Thus, the elements of G satisfy closure axiom. We shall now prove the associativity. For this, let us consider A, B, C belong to G. We three arbitrary elements in G. We have to show that A star B star C equal to A star B star C. First, let us consider A star B star C value. That is equals to, since we know that A star B is nothing but sum of A and B minus product of A and B. Therefore, first we are going to find the value of B star C. Then what is B star C? In the value of B, we consider A, C as B. Then B star C will be B plus C minus B into C. Therefore, this equals to A star B star C is B plus C minus B into C. This is by the definition of star. Now, we have to find the value of A star B plus C minus BC. Here, consider A as A and B as the whole element. The whole element, namely B plus C minus BC as B. A is A, B plus C minus B C as B. Therefore, this becomes now A star B plus C minus B C becomes A is A. What is B? B is B plus C minus B C minus A into, what is B now? B plus C minus B C. That is the one here. A plus, the whole thing is like B, minus A into B. Let us multiply. This equals to A plus B plus C minus BC minus AB minus AC minus of minus plus ABC. Thus, the value of A star B star C is A plus B minus BC minus AB minus AC plus ABC. Let us call it as 1. We will now find the value of A star B star C. What is A star B? A star B is A plus B minus AB star C. Now consider this A plus B minus AB as a single element A and C as B. Then this will be of the form A star C. See, this will be like A. And the C will be like B. Then this is of the form A star B. What is A star B? A star B is A plus B minus AB. That is equals to A plus B minus AB plus C minus A plus B minus AB into C. That is equals to A plus B minus AB plus C minus A into C plus b into c. Since we have minus sign outside, we have to write minus ac, minus bc, minus of minus plus abc. That can be rewritten as a plus b plus c minus ab minus bc minus ac plus a plus b plus abc. That is called it as 2. Now look at the right hand side of 1 and 2. Right hand side of 1 is a plus b plus c. Here also a plus b plus c. Minus ab minus ab minus bc minus bc minus ac minus ac plus abc plus abc. Thus the right hand side of 1 and 2 are equal, and hence the left hand side of 1 and 2 must be equal. Therefore, from 1 and 2 we can write a star b star c equals to a star b star c. Now we will find what is the identity element of the given set. The definition for existence of identity or the identity axioms is, for all A belong to G, there exists E belongs to G such that A star E equals to A equal to E star A. Now our aim is to find the value of E. To find the value of E, you can take either A star E equal to A or E star A equals to A. Now consider A star E equals to A. We are going to find the value of E. What is A star E? A star E will be of the form A star B. In the value, in the place of B, we have E. Therefore, A star E will be A E A plus E minus A E equals to A. Now take this A to left hand side, or bring this A to the right hand side so that A minus A get cancelled, and hence E minus AE equal to 0. So E is a common factor, take it out. So E into 1 minus A equal to 0. That implies either E equal to 0 or 1 minus A equal to 0. If 1 minus A equal to 0, we get A equal to 1. But since A belongs to G, A cannot be 1. That is, when you say A belongs to G, A is any rational number except 1. Therefore, the only possibility is E equal to 0. And hence, E equal to 0 is the identity element in G. Now, we have to show that inverse exists for every element in the set G, where G is set of all rational numbers other than 1. The inverse axiom is, for all A belong to G, that exists B belongs to G such that A star B equals to E equal to B star A. To find, since we have taken A, we are going to find the value of B. Just now we have shown that, or we have derived, or we got the value of E as 0. Therefore, to get the value of B, we use either A star B equal to E or B star A equal to E. Here we consider A star B equals to E. We know that A star B is defined as A plus B minus A into B. Therefore, we have A plus B minus A into B, where E is the identity whose value is 0. Now our aim is to find the value of B. Therefore, take this A to the right hand side. Now, between these two terms, B is a common factor. Therefore, take B out. Hence, we get B into 1 minus A equal to minus A. Now dividing by 1 minus A, because A is not equal to 0, which is possible. So B equal to minus A by 1 minus A. Since A is not equal to 1, this cannot be 0 and hence minus A by 1 minus A is defined. What is B? B is the inverse of A. Therefore, the inverse of A is B, whose value is minus A by 1 minus A. Therefore, inverse of A is minus A by 1 minus A. What is the inverse of 3? The inverse of 3 will be minus 3 by 1 minus 3. That is minus 3 by minus 2, that is equal to 3 by 2. That is the inverse of 3. What's the inverse of 5? Inverse of 5 will be minus 5 by minus 4. That is 5 by 4. What is the inverse of 1? No. We should not find inverse of 1. Why? Because 1 is not there in the set G. What's inverse of 2? Minus 2 by 1 minus 2 is minus 2 by minus 1 is 2. Inverse of 2 is 2. Inverse of 3 is 3 by 2. Thus, we can find the inverse of each and every element in G. And hence, inverse axiom is satisfied. The last one is commutativity. That says that if A comma B belong to G, then A circle B must be equals to B star A. That is, A star B must be equal to B star A. Let us find the value of A star B. A star B is A plus B minus AB. What are A and B? A and B are rational numbers. Therefore, this can be written as B plus A. A plus B equal to B plus A. And AB equal to BA. Nothing wrong in it. Because set of rational numbers work commutative property with respect to addition and with respect to multiplication. Therefore, B plus A minus BA is nothing but B star A. Thus, A star B equal to B star A. G comma star is an abelian group.